Echo Park. This is Amy Taylor here, and I'm here with Mr. David Allen. Thank you for being with us
today.
Mr. David Allen is a fashion designer located here in Pittsburgh. This is a special edition of Healthy, Fit, and Strong, and we're going to talk about the work that he's done designing specialty face masks, as well as his charitable contributions here in the Pittsburgh area, and lastly, his fitness wear that he's designing for women. Talk to us a little bit, Mr. David, about what it was that made you start designing clothing. You started off in high school designing clothing, I'm guessing?
I did not. I started designing clothing when I was 27 years old. So
what happened between then?
Prior to being in the clothing world, I was in medical sales, and I always knew that the top doctors that I dealt with dressed the best, and the top sales reps that I became close with were successful and dressed the best. And I realized quickly the power of fashion. When you walk into a place, you can really command a lot of respect and set the expectations without saying anything and even opening your mouth, purely off of appearance. And I just really saw the value of what it could do psychologically for a person, even the confidence that it gives you to want to work a little bit harder, to want to work a little bit longer. I fortunately had a lot of flexibility when I was in medical, and you know, I could work from 10 to 2 p.m. and be done and still live a good life and do very well financially. And then one day I dressed a little bit differently, and I got a bunch of compliments from the office staff. And the next day I wore the same exact outfit to a different region in my territory, and I just felt amazing, and I wanted to work longer and work harder. And from that point, it really hit home for me what fashion can do for you.
Yeah, and that reminds me of the saying, don't dress for the job that you have, dress for the job that you desire.
Sure.
That's right, because if you aspire to get a better job, you aspire to be a better person, you dress accordingly.
Absolutely, yeah.
And I see that you're dressed quite dapper for us today.
Thank you.
Tell me a little bit about the shirt that you're wearing.
Yeah, just during COVID, I figured I would dress up a little bit because it's been 3 months of not really getting an opportunity to dress up and stand out. But just a short sleeve button down that we designed about a year and a half ago. And I tried to dress a little bit different, buttoning to the top just to stand out. And I got tattoos from a fashion standpoint as well. And it's everything
that
I have tattooed on my arm is pretty much about my journey in 5 years of building clothing.
Oh, can you really briefly talk to us about that? I see your name or your logo.
Yeah, so I have my logo up here. I actually have a proper knot designed on my arm as well.
And buttons.
Each
tell a story.
So I always, every one of our clients, we typically educate them on the last buttonhole stitch to change the color. So as you can see, I did the red on the last stitch there. Negative $86.40 was actually my bank account in 2016. So it obviously was a very low point for me. And I look down at it every day and kind of really get a meaningful
perspective
on it. Yeah. I have my parents' initials on cufflinks there.
That's
just
because
really cool. They've been, you know, behind me the whole way.
Some of the friends that you made in college work for you today.
Yeah, I have a couple of really great friends of mine. Actually, Alvin, who started the business with me 5.5 years ago, was even before the clothing, he was wearing proper knots for me. And we played football together at Duquesne. And then Krista, who came on board to run our women's side of the company as well and really helped grow that. So just the people I've met along the way, and my creative director, him and I went to college together, and then our digital marketing specialist as well went to college with me.
Wonderful.
Yeah, so we literally have a team of everybody from Duquesne that's
people that you trust and know and that believe in you.
Absolutely, yeah.
That's
And the one thing we've learned with the group that we have now is just the one thing you can't teach is who they are, and the other things are the benefits that they can learn and grow in as far as the business side of it. But you know, we've been through a handful of people over the last 5 years, and we have always gotten burned, but it was hiring the wrong people. And now that we have a core group of people that first and foremost are good human beings, I think that's the true definition of the foundation of an organization.
That's right. And the people that you surround yourself with really should rise you up.
Absolutely,
you know,
for sure.
Rise you up to the occasion.
For sure.
I want to talk to you about a couple of the products that you have manufacturing nowadays. This is one of your face masks.
Correct.
This is gorgeous.
Thank you.
Handmade, and you have a logo. We're in this together with your logo, David Allen, on it. And I see that it comes in different sizes, small, medium, and large. So it's for kids, it's for teens, it's for adults,
yep.
It's for all face sizes. And this one in particular has the blue stripe for the police respect. Talk to me a little bit about what made you make this mask.
Yeah, a lot of it is just when we started the business, it was a lot about philanthropic ventures that we could have. And, you know, the first responders, police, fire, EMS, and we're just always trying to take care of people and help, because those are jobs that are not glorified at all. And especially in today's world, there's a lot of negativity around that. And I do believe there has to be some changes that take place with just society and growth in general. But at the end of the day, those people choose their opportunities and their careers, and the good ones that are out there really are great, great people and really want to do good and help out. So it's just kind of a subtle thank you to them, and you know, how we are literally all in this together from every aspect of the spectrum.
Mm-hmm. Instead of your tipping of the hat, you're actually tipping of the mask to them.
Yeah, you could say that.
I
for
like
sure.
That a
yeah,
lot.
Yeah. And I especially, like, I mean, you can't see anybody's mouth now, so
yeah.
It's a nice way that you can make eye contact and just know there's a smile beneath a mask.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate the fact that you're doing this for our first responders.
Yeah, what it's important.
Thing.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
And I want to talk to you about your proper knot.
Sure.
This is where it all began?
This is where it began in 2014 is when I had the idea.
And what, talk to me about the idea process.
Yep.
It just came to you in a dream. It came to you in a vision. How did you come up with the idea for the perfect knot? Because it's genius.
Yeah, so whenever, thank you very much. So when I, before I even got into the proper knot, I had a necktie business. And I had three business partners with that company. And that was about 10 years ago. And what we did was I was traveling, doing medical sales all over the country, and I would golf in every city that I would go to. Every Monday I was on a plane, and every Friday I was on a plane home.
Wow.
So I spent a lot of time in, you know, Montana, Wyoming, all over the country in these beautiful areas, different country clubs in Florida. And the one thing I noticed, that no golf shop sold neckties. So, but people would go and spend $100 and $120 on a golf polo because it had the golf course logo on it. So I just realized at that point, well, golf's an expensive sport. You have to have money to golf. And I would assume a lot of the people that are golfers wear neckties in some capacity in their life. So we would basically make neckties with a golf course logo on them, sell them to the pro shop, and then they would sell them in turn there. So we did that for about 4 years, and then it became more of a hobby for my business partners. And I just had this goal of how can we really do something to have our own business. And after 4 years, we kind of all dissolved the company and walked away. And at the tail end of that, I had saw a necktie that if you tied it a certain way, the knot would be a different color. But for me, I was 26-ish, 25 at the time, and I had my standard 10 neckties that I wore every week, and I would rotate those, and I didn't have the means at that point to buy 100 neckties. So I just said, hey, I have these ones that I really like. How can I make them look a little bit different? And not have to spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars to do that. So I just said, let's take the idea of the necktie that if you tied it a certain way, the knot was a different color, and then recreate it. So then we took that product a step further and started putting logos of professional sports teams, college, universities, things of that nature. And that was where we really wanted to make a push at that point. When I started the proper knot, I hired a lady that was hand making them for me. And she was taking 3 or 4 weeks to get me 10 of them. And I realized that I would never be able to scale a business at that point. So I went to Joann Fabrics and I bought a sewing machine, and then I taught myself how to sew. So as orders—
How'd that go for you?
It was pretty brutal. I think the first knot that I made took 2.5 hours.
2.5 hours?
And then I sewed it backwards. So it was a long journey. And then I think the quickest I got to was 11 minutes or so per knot. And during that time, I was still sourcing materials from overseas, trying to get mass manufacturing, but I knew I had to keep things going from a sales standpoint on my end, on what I can control. So I would do my medical job during the day, and then in the evening,
wow,
I would just go home and sew, and sometimes not go to bed for 2 days or so, and, you know, naps here and there just to kind of to get by. But
that's passion.
Yeah, the beginning was very, very, very difficult. It was very challenging for me, but it was, you just kind of keep in the back of your mind that you can get through it, and there's an ending goal to why I was doing it, and, you know, here we are today. So.
Wow, and I just want to display some of these lovely proper knots. This one has the Steeler logo on it. This has your alma mater.
Absolutely,
of,
yeah,
Duquesne. We have Florida Gators, UCLA. See, I know my college.
You do,
dudes.
Absolutely,
I,
yeah,
know them, right?
They're not, these ones aren't for sale, because we don't have licensing set up or anything yet. And we just kind of use those as samples. And our goal this year was to push the proper knot and really get it licensed to a lot of big universities and professional sports teams. And then with all the licensing expos that were canceled this year, it just kind of put it on hold for a little bit longer. But we have a patent, and I think we have about 16 nice. Years left on that. So yeah. We have some time.
For those of you at home that are unfamiliar with the proper knot, it is, in fact, a sheath of very nice fabric that goes over top of the knot at the top of your necktie. The Windsor knot?
Yeah, it gives you like kind of a full Windsor look, so mm-hmm. it gives you the perfect triangle look mm-hmm. for it.
And it comes in a variety of colors. So if you're wearing your necktie, it actually changes the look of the suit, changes the look of the tie, just by adding a simple feature, which is the proper knot. And you also did work with the American Cancer Society.
We did, yes.
And that was with a pink proper knot.
Correct. Yeah.
Talk
so
to
we
me about that.
We had a national partnership with the American Cancer Society back in 2016, and I was nominated for a group called Real Men Wear Pink, and it was the first kickoff all over the country for a group in every city of, I think, 10 to 20 men that were in different professions, different careers, and their goal was to raise money for breast cancer awareness. Mm-hmm. We partnered them for our first fashion show that we had, and we just came up with an idea and just said, hey, we should fly a bunch of celebrities that we work with into Pittsburgh, have a big fashion show, and try to pull off something that nobody's really done in the city before. And the day of the fashion show, we had no idea if anybody was going to make their flights. You know, you're dealing with celebrities for the first time, and,
sure.
and you hear different stories about everybody. And as the flights started taking off that day with confirmed one celebrity on there, the next one, it started coming together and really saying, okay, this is going to happen. And then up until the event, we had no idea if there was going to be three people or 300, and I think we had about 380 people at our first fashion show. It was awesome. We raised
it was in Pittsburgh?
It was in Pittsburgh in the Strip District, and mm-hmm. we raised I think about $17,000 for the American Cancer
Very
Society.
Nice.
It was awesome.
What made you do that for the American Cancer Society?
I don't know.
You lost someone?
I haven't. No.
Your cousin?
No. So I had a cousin of mine was a couple cousins were diagnosed with different variations of cancer. I've lost close friends from it in the past, and partnering with the American Cancer Society, I think just knowing so many women that fight that and go through that, and at that point it was something that we really wanted to combat and fight with. So. I had some friends at the organization as well and really wanted to get involved with them. And so just there's
Is the pink proper knot available for purchase for those who want
it
to
is,
pay
yes.
their respects to breast cancer or cancer awareness?
Correct. Yeah, we still have all of the proper knots, the standard colors, and then we have some patterned ones on our website,
nice.
Which is just properknot.com. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so we still have a ton of inventory of those as well.
Mm-hmm. And what about your work with the women's fashion industry? Talk to me a little bit about that. That's so exciting.
Yeah, we knew as we were growing the business and as we were kind of expanding, that was a market. You know, women like to spend money and they like to shop and they like different things, right?
That's right.
And I think, honestly, I don't think there's much of a difference. I think men, once they figure out all you can do, I think that they appreciate it as well. Mm-hmm. And I think the way that society has shifted, it's becoming more acceptable for men to dress a little bit different. So
Yes, very much so.
You know, I think the women have carved the way, especially for the customization or wanting to be different. But this was the year we really wanted to take off with our women's line. And we were on last year in 2019 on a show on the E! Network called Total Divas. And I did a suit for one of the WWE divas named Sonya Deville. And she's the first openly gay WWE diva. And so we did a really, really cool outfit for her. And she got to walk the runway wearing our stuff in the red carpet event.
Very cool.
Yeah, we had a nice, portion where we were on the episode as well.
Very
so
nice. And
awesome.
You've done work with other members of the WWE as
yes,
well.
Yes, correct, yeah.
You design suits and loungewear for them.
Yeah, so most of the stuff that we do is more the professional side for that.
Mm-hmm.
We're starting to get into more casual wear. But for the majority of the time that we've been in business, it's all been higher-end professional for their red carpet events, Hall of Fame events, things of that nature.
Mm-hmm.
So we work probably with 40 of the WWE roster, maybe a little bit more by now. And, you know, they trusted me in 2016 when somebody just said, hey, you got to meet this guy, and really have been so supportive of me since and the team and the brand since we've started.
Mm-hmm. And when can this women's line of fitness wear be available?
So we're launching, that's kind of a different play with what we're doing, is we're launching another product underneath the David Allen umbrella, but it will be branded different. And that's with Jenny Fairley, who's JWoww on Jersey Shore. And
really cool.
Yeah, so we're trying to launch for Black Friday of this year is our target. We don't want to miss that date. So it's going to be a higher-end yoga apparel and fitness apparel.
You're hearing it first, Bethel Park people. Yeah. You're hearing this first.
Yeah, we haven't really told too many people about it. So
well, don't worry. We won't tell anybody. Keep it hush-hush.
Yeah, so our goal is to launch Black Friday of this year, and then we want to get into hopefully Target in the springtime of 2021.
Yes.
And, you know, we're just trying to do what we've done in the clothing world and provide a high-end product for an affordable price point, and to be able to reach the masses is kind of our goal with everything.
And I want to talk a little bit about, just name drop a few names of some celebrities / WWE people that you design and dress exclusively.
Yeah, so we've done a lot for John Cena is probably our biggest client.
Amazing.
We've been fortunate to be included in the new Fast and the Furious movie that's coming out.
Oh.
There's a couple other projects that he's done in the last couple years. All of his movie premieres since 2017 have all been with our clothing on, which has been awesome. Ric Flair, who's a statement in the wrestling community, arguably one of the biggest names in wrestling history. We do a lot of his clothing. Wrestler after wrestler that we've done work with, Titus O'Neil,
yes.
The New Day is a group of three gentlemen that are a tag team trio. Sonya Deville, we've branched into her side of things. And then we've even stepped out of the WWE and worked with a lot of NFL players, movie stars. Christian Navarro, who's become a good friend of mine, he's on a show called 13 Reasons Why, which is on Netflix.
And he wears your clothes?
Yeah, so we did. So I think his name's Tony on the show. And we did the MTV
That's
movie
a really
awards
popular show for your clothing to be.
Yeah, for sure. We've been very fortunate. It's just been, it's weird. One person after another just trusts us and looks into what we're doing. And I think because we don't want anything from anybody, we just want to help people. And I think
you're a genuine company.
We are. And everybody in our team is the same way, which is awesome. And they care about the client, right? And they care about providing a good service and a good product. And I think that catches on to people, especially in a world where there's just so much spewed at you. There's a lot that you have to filter through. So whenever you find something and you filter through it and you find that trust, I think it helps out immensely for everything.
And you do work with the NFL players, the Pittsburgh Steelers specifically?
We do, yeah. I mean, a ton of NFL teams, but we're fortunate enough to do Ryan Shazier's wedding.
Nice.
Yeah, so whenever he had his horrific accident, he had the lion with the lion head, and that was his logo. So whenever he called me to do the tuxedo for him, I wanted to incorporate his personal life experiences into the outfit. So what we did was we blended the lion on the back of his tuxedo jacket, and we just made it a shade different than what the actual, it was a pinkish jacket. So we wanted to have a darker tone underneath to highlight it, but not to really take away from anything else that was going there.
That's so cool.
Stefan Tuitt's a great client and supporter of our business. Roosevelt Nix, who just left. Tyler Medikevich, who just left. Sean Davis, we did his wedding suit. He unfortunately just left. So we're going through a transitional phase with a lot of guys. But for us, it's kind of a benefit because now we get an opportunity to get into the locker room of another NFL team.
Right.
You know, I have to go to New Orleans in a couple weeks to work with some of the Saints. Anthony Ciccolo, who was a former Steeler, is now on the Saints team, so he called me to come down there. So as much as you hate to see them leave
the
town, because
but
build...
they're spreading your word.
Correct.
That's exactly right. Juju,
yeah,
Bettis.
So we've done stuff for Juju. We just did one jacket for him a couple years ago. It was the Juju Claus, where they highlighted him as a Santa Claus, and he was at Robinson Mall. So we did some stuff with him for that, and haven't done anything with Jerome Bettis yet. Really good friends with his brother and his nephew, and I just we actually just did his nephew's wedding.
Oh, nice.
So we just got a lot of
great
time.
His mother came to your fundraiser, too.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, she walked and...
The whole Bettis family, I think, surrounds you and supports you.
Absolutely, yeah. John was actually a counterpart of mine in The Real Men Wear Pink. So that's why his mom was at the event and everything, which was awesome. So, yeah, they're a very great family, though.
This is all fabulous, fabulous news. I want to showcase a few of your pieces. Just give me some highlights of what brought these to light.
So this piece here.
Okay. This is so beautiful. I've said it before. It looks like it belongs on a rack at Rodeo Drive. This is stunning.
Thank you. Yeah, we started doing bomber jackets, which is really this. It's a lighter outer jacket. We started doing these about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and people have absolutely loved those. So what we do is we just work with every client individually, kind of talk them through what do they need the garment for, what type of an event, and you kind of get to know their personal style as well. So we really make sure we point them in the right direction. A lot of the times, too, how it works is we'll sit down with a client and, you know, tell me a little bit about what you want, and then it takes a day or two for my mind or our stylist mind to really dive into it. And, you know, the gentleman that we worked specifically with this had a pair of shoes that he wanted to kind of incorporate into his overall outfit, was still doing kind of a high-end design look and feel. So we just kind of did the contrasting sleeves, contrasting pockets here, which a lot of these colors are going to flow through the shoes that he's wearing as well. And then we love the gold look on this because I think it just fits the...
Oh, that makes it pop.
Yeah, it really, really sits nicely with everything here. So nothing crazy from a design other than kind of alternating the colors and patterns, more inspired by the shoes that he really wanted to pull together with these.
Mm-hmm.
But
that's
it's,
beautiful.
Yeah, we love the bomber jackets. We've been very pleased with those.
We have this gorgeous suit.
Yep, so this one...
Is it safe to say you're known for your suits? You specialize in suits?
Yeah, that's the majority of our business is professional wear. You know, and it just, you know, it depends on who the client is and what they're looking for. And what we try to do is just offer as many services and products as we possibly can, because we know that not everybody's going to wear a suit every single day. And we realize that there are going to be, you know, different events and style is drastically and rapidly changing. You know, so we wanted to really stand out and be different. And
that's exactly what your wear is. It's different.
For sure.
And I can understand why John Cena would want only you to be dressing him, because he is a unique and special individual.
Sure.
And your clothing and your designs are unique and special, and I love them all.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, this is actually a lady, Michelle Jubilier. She is the COO of Capitol Records. So it's kind of like a Gucci-inspired look. We saw a couple garments that were similar to this. We took a couple of the what she liked about it and what she didn't like about the other look, and we kind of made a bunch of tweaks. So it has a general flow of that, but it's more of an Asian-styled garment, and it's more of a relaxed fit as well. So excited to get this in her hands for sure.
This is one of my favorite pieces. Oh, my gosh. Oh.
Yeah, this one's pretty cool here.
It looks regal. It looks like royalty. Look at this blue velvet. You know.
Yeah, so this is kind of a light jacket or a shirt jacket. And the purpose of this was just kind of have something fashionable for the days where it gets a little bit chilly, or you just wanted to have a different style for the most part. And, you know, so we put the Italian velvet on the cuff and on the base of the jacket. And, again, just kind of something different.
Even the pockets. Look at this.
Yeah, we did just the triangle flaps for the pocket here, and we threw the buttons just to actually hide the button. So whenever it's fastened, you button it underneath, and it just sits tight there, which is really cool. And then we did the client signature on the...
Look at this. This actually has the client signature on it.
Yeah, so we had them sign a piece of paper, and we take a PDF picture of that, and then we upload that, and we can kind of print that anywhere on the jacket, which is really cool. So we're trying to push these for the fall and then the spring of 2021 as we really just started sampling these products.
Two more that I really want to talk about.
Sure.
Look at this. Hold this one up and flip it over.
Yep. So this one, actually, Krista worked on here, and she worked with one of the clients. And on the back, you can kind of see the high center slit there, which is probably 6 or 7 inches longer than a traditional slit in a jacket. And it was something that Krista and the client really decided they wanted to be unique, and it turned out incredible.
Look at the buttons that have the butterfly, the inside lining that has the butterfly. You said this particular client had an affection for butterflies.
Sure, yeah.
Talk to me a little bit about this client.
Yeah, so what she did with this was she just kind of sat down with Chris, and she really wanted a unique piece. She's used to shopping in the areas of Beverly Hills that we talked about earlier, and so to come into Pittsburgh and get these, there's really not any places to do that. So I know Krista spent, you know, weeks working with her trying to get this the exactly way she wanted, and even simplifying it and putting the butterfly circle button on the center, and then the true shape of the butterfly on the cuffs has been really, really cool. This is one of my favorite pieces. And then she did the pouch or patch pockets on the side just to be a little bit different here, which are pretty cool.
Oh, yeah. That is. I didn't even notice it was on the side. Yep. And a lot of your fabrics, you say, are imported?
Yeah, it depends. So we have fabric really from every country in the world. From the textile standpoint, you know, we have Italian fabrics, we have English cloth. It really depends on price point of the client, what their wants, what their needs are, and we can source pretty much anything at this point.
Wow. One more piece. David, am I saving the best for last?
This one's really cool, yeah.
Me? Oh my goodness
awesome.
Sakes.
So this is...
hold that bad boy up.
Yeah, this is for Sean Davis, who was former Pittsburgh Steeler, and he called us to do his wedding, so we wanted to do something very unique. And so the outside here, we did the spider web.
Get a close-up of this here.
Spider web velvet here. And then on the lapels here, we have like a snakeskin type feel as well. So when this hits like ballroom lighting, it's a lot darker, and then there's a lot more sparkles, and a really, really unique piece for that. And then the inside, we just did some Viking stuff on here.
Amazing.
Just a big fan of those. So
that's just a stunning piece. All of them unique and wonderful in their own ways.
Yeah, so we, back whenever COVID started really knocking every business down, we made a decision on April 3rd of this year and just said, hey, you know, the suit business is probably going to go away or go quiet for a while with everything happening, and we have to pivot and figure out a way to do this. So what we did was came up with the idea on April 3rd, and by the evening of April 4th, we had a company launched, and where we specialize in making high-end face masks for protection. What we did that a lot of people don't know of is the masks are actually made out of our dress shirt material, and so they're a lot more high-end too. And they're three-layer cotton. They have a nanotechnology on there, so it's like a water resistance. So if the exterior gets wet, it will just beat up and drop right off, which is really nice. So we've been very fortunate. We timed that right whenever everybody really needed them. We were one of the first companies to actually produce those across the country, and we had an amazing amount of support. So what we've done with that is we're taking a portion of the proceeds. We donated some to the COVID-19 Relief Fund. And then on top of that, we're going to be partnering with an organization at Allegheny Health Network, the Alexis Joy Foundation, and they specialize in postpartum for women after their, you know, give birth to their child. And we are partnering with them where we're going to take care of mortgages for about four or five families for the back half of 2020, and kind of give them some financial relief who've been hit hard in some other ways as well. And if we can be a small part of glimmer of hope for them to kind of get through everything and keep fighting, that's really what we're doing. And we wouldn't be able to do that without the support of everybody and the support of our team as well to pivot, because it was tough when we launched this, and the stress that we went through for 2.5 to 3 weeks was more than people probably have any idea, because we're trying to get a product out there that's in extreme high demand, and you know, after we launched a company in 24 hours is not ideal. But we fought through everything, and you know, I think we sold about 120,000 masks in a short amount of time, which we were very, very fortunate for.
Mm-hmm. And I think that your work with the masks, your work with your philanthropic, just your charitable give back speaks volumes about who David Allen is as a person, who David Allen Corporation, David Allen Fashion, David Allen Designs is. This business gives back to the community. They give back to those in need. As much as it comes in the door, it goes out the door. And that says a lot about who and what David Allen is, both
Thank
as
you.
A person and both as a company. Thank you.
Yeah, we understand that it's a competitive world out there, and we understand that the world that we live in general. And we've just built the business off of just doing what's right, being good to other people, and taking care of people. And
yeah.
I think that message goes hidden a lot nowadays, especially with social media, the way things are, and you know, the news in general, just they shove negativity down your face on a regular basis. So there's so many good people, not just us, other people as well, that are doing great things that should be more the focus or center of attention than what's actually happening. And so I appreciate that a lot. But again, if it wasn't for all the support that we've had and the team that we have, our brand wouldn't be anything. So it's a thank you to everybody that's really kind of trusted us when we were nobody and when we really didn't have any experience. And to the point of now, there's people who are still supporting us and still kind of getting our name out there. So it's more of a community thank you than anything for us, because without them, we wouldn't be in our position at all.
We'll be right back.